in 1975, or slightly before, Reclamation had been given the responsibility of building the Yuma Desalting Plant. The Yuma Desalting Plant was built to allow the government to meet the requirements of Minute 242 of the International Boundary and Waters Commission. And they had made an agreement, Minute 242, that said the water that is delivered to Mexico at Morales Dam, which is the first Mexican dam south of the border on the Colorado, would not be more than, I believe it was 130 ppm, more saline than the water released from Imperial Dam, which was the last U.S. structure. They wanted at the same time to be able to put the drainage water from the Welton Mohawk Drainage District into the Colorado. And that was running about 3,200 ppm, whereas the Imperial Dam numbers were typically 700 or 800. And so when they first put this water in, the water delivered to Mexico was very saline. And that's what started the negotiations that led to Minute 242. So the Yuma Desalting Plant was not built to provide a municipal water supply or an industrial water supply. It was built to settle a political issue. One of the first things I did was, with this rather complex requirement, how do we size the desalting plant? And the plant was at one point going to be 104 MGD, and finally, before the plant was built, it got reduced to 73 MGD. Big desalting plants in those days were 2 or 3 million gallons a day. It was a huge step forward. In building this plant, we did several interesting things. I hear from the Israelis occasionally how pleased they are that they invented a power center where they have all of the pumps grouped in one place, and they power all the water instead of having one pump attached to several racks of elements, which was the standard design for small plants. Well, we had a power center in our 1970s design. We also had an energy recovery system. And this was a Pelton wheel, which was the technology of the day, attached to the same axis as one of the pumps. So we did not go through converting it back to electrical energy and then back to pressure. But I think the biggest thing we did was big. That was not meant to be a pun. Was develop big elements. In 1975, the standard element was a 4-inch diameter element for reverse osmosis and some 36 to 40 inches long. Well, working with the Office of Saline Water, they sponsored a research for large elements. We wound up procuring from Hydronautics and from Fluid Systems. Hydronautics came up with an 8.5-inch diameter element, and Fluid Systems came up with a 12-inch diameter unit. And they made a very long one. They increased the length to 60 inches. And our procurement of those elements was really what made the manufacture of a reverse osmosis equipment a practical reality.